Well, have you ever wished you could get away on your own and have a good cry? Well, if you're travelling to Japan anytime soon, you can do just that in a specialised crying room designated to combat stress while allowing you to sob in elegance and comfort. Complete with soft tissues, face masks, makeup removers and a selection of beautiful films, you can take the day to let loose and find some peace of mind.
We actually have those at Channel 10. They're called dressing rooms.
Malcolm, I'm sure in the wonderful world of politics and business you've wanted to have a good cry. Would you love a little crying room at Parliament House?
Yeah, I think practically any room in Parliament House is designated for that purpose. But I read that report, Tasha, and it's designated only for women though. So this is a case of incredible discrimination against the men of Japan.
They've just got
to toughen up, and the Japanese women are invited to these crying rooms.
Well, Neville Rand famously said Balmain boys don't cry, and the idea that, you know, politics in particular, men in general, but politics in particular, it's a tough game. You've got to have a skin of a leather hide. Do you ever, like, with all the criticism that politicians get, and I think sometimes it's too much, do you ever just go somewhere
Come
by yourself?
On, say that again with sincerity.
But is there ever a time when a little tear runs down your face where you actually go, you know what, that really hurts. I'm sick of people picking on me and saying I'm wrong about everything and that I'm an idiot and I'm, you know, not that they'd ever say that a bit, but, you know. Does it hurt your feelings?
I've never been moved to tears about criticism of myself, but I think you know, politicians do need to have very thick skins, and if you have a thin skin and if you've got a sort of a sense of entitlement, I mean, some politicians run the risk of getting resentful that anybody would criticise them. I mean, you've got to recognise you sign up for.
Do you cry? Are there times when you've had a cry?
Oh, I do, absolutely.
And when's that?
I'll give you an example recently. Lucy and I have a daughter, Daisy, who has a little boy who's 19 months old. Jax is our first grandchild, and our daughter-in-law and son are having a baby very soon, a little girl, so we'll have a granddaughter soon, which is great. But I took, we were at a park, and I took Jack on a, you know, carousel, a merry-go-round, you know, and sat him on the little horse and, you know, held him there. And I was moved to tears because I thought, how cool is this? You know, here I am, I'm his granddad, and this is his first ride on a merry-go-round, and I'll start crying now. But it was, you know, that's the sort of thing that makes me cry more often. Anyway, there you go.
Malcolm, can I ask you a question? In regards to leaders or politicians seem they can't win at the moment because if they're too hard, they're seen as unemotional and not compassionate. But how do you get that great balance between being compassionate but being strong?
Well, I think compassion is a sign of strength. I mean, this is being compassionate is all about strength. Look, the bottom line is in politics, you just got to be yourself. It's like in your whole life. I mean, if you spend your life in politics trying to be somebody else, you won't convince anybody, and B, you'll actually lose sight of who you really are. And that's, I think you've just got to be yourself.
Which has happened very recently to a number of leaders.
It's
interesting. Bill Shorten did a whole bunch of focus groups and they all told him to be himself, so that's what he's doing.